burdening yourself for your guest. Burdening yourself for your guest. As a rule, طيب, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم نهى عن التكلف. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم نهى عن تكلف. As Umar رضي الله تعالى said, we were forbidden from تكلف. What is meaning of تكلف? Affectation and going to extravagant troubles. It means that I do something beyond my ability. يعني for example, I have guests, 3 guests, and I am a simple employee. I'm not earning money except from my job, and it is what is enough for me and my family. So now I have guests. I invite them in a food in a 5-star hotel. No, this is forbidden. Because this will consume all my salary. So after that, I will beg people and ask them to help me in money. No, this is haram. This is haram. Okay, so how should we behave? That you give what you can afford. Wallahi, I can slaughter a sheep for my guest and it's okay for me financially. Do that. You can slaughter a camel. Okay, do that for him. Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much. But you cannot. Or you can slaughter only a chicken. Do it. Half a chicken. Okay. You cannot afford that. Maybe you can provide dates. Do that. I mean, do what you can do. Up to your limits. Don't go beyond that. This is forbidden in Islam. And be sure that the Prophet ﷺ said, this is a very nice hadith mentioned in this chapter. The food of one is sufficient for two. The food for two is sufficient for four. And the food of four is sufficient for eight. Muslims should realize this concept. This is very important concept in Islam, brothers and sisters. The barakah, the blessings. There is hadith, a nice hadith. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam milked the sheep for him, or the goat for him. So they brought the milk to this man. He drank the cup. Again, they milked another sheep. This man drank the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, the sixth, 7 cups. Or 7 times milking the sheep for him. Or different 7 sheep. Then this man slept. Tomorrow, he woke up. He said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. He accepted Islam. Alhamdulillah. Why? Allahu alam. Maybe because of the manners of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He liked Islam. He liked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The point is, he became Muslim. After that, the Prophet ﷺ said to the companion, Allah, bring the milk for him. So he drank the first cup, Bismillah. Now he's Muslim. He says, Bismillah. He finished the first cup. Then they milked for him the second cup. He drank from the second and he did not finish the second cup. Why? The Prophet ﷺ said, المؤمن يأكل في معين واحد والكافر يشرب في 7 أمعاء. The believer drinks with 1 stomach, while the kafir, the disbeliever, drinks with 7 stomachs. Subhanallah. يعني they mention more than one meaning. والله أعلم that يعني the Muslim, one of the meanings or one of the opinions of this hadith, the scholars say, the hadith means that the Muslim thinks about the Akhirah. My aim is not this dunya. My aim is the Akhirah, the hereafter. So I will not do everything in this dunya. Not like the kafir. The kafir likes to do everything in dunya. He likes to eat the food. He likes every time to fill his stomach. He likes to try all kinds of food, all kinds of restaurants. So that's why he eats a lot. And subhanAllah, now many Muslims, we in the Muslim countries, okay, or the Muslims generally, I will not say all of us, but many of us, we are doing like the kuffar and eating the food, subhanAllah. We like to enjoy the food. We enjoy the, yani, how many times You notice that we choose this, okay, yalla, let's meet. Where we meet? Our meeting in the restaurant, subhanAllah. Not like the companions. When they meet in the masjid. They meet when, with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in halqa. But nowadays, many Muslims, I will not say all, many Muslims, where to meet? In the coffee, in the restaurant, in the hotel, subhanAllah. There should be food. We should eat, we should drink. Tayyib, this is one thing. Another thing, okay, where to meet? In any restaurant? No, not any restaurant. Last week we tried that restaurant, the food was not okay. We should try another restaurant. Okay, after that, last week the restaurant was nice, the food was perfect, but not nice view. Let's go to another, subhanAllah. So this is our concern as Muslims. We should wake up, brothers and sisters. Wake up. Work for your akhirah. Work for your akhirah, paradise. So the blessings, this is very important, brothers and sisters. And also there is something important. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam naha an ta'am al-mutbariyayn an yu'kal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam naha an ta'am al-mutbariyayn, forbade people from eating the food of competitors. That means people who compete to serve the most extravagant banquet. Okay, and for example, we are friends. Okay, welcome tonight. I'm inviting you for dinner. Okay, so I order food from this restaurant. So after the dinner, everyone is happy and they are thanking me. Jazakallah khair, brother Ahmed. It was a delicious food, the dessert, the main dish, salad, everything. Okay, then one of the brothers said, tomorrow I invite you for lunch. Why? Because he wants us to be happy? No. He wants to compete me. Then, if you come to know that this is the reason, don't attend. This is forbidden. This is forbidden. طيب. Number 6. الدخول, enter only after having obtained permission and leave after the meal is over. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَدْخُلُوا بُيُوتَ النَّبِيِّ إِلَّا أَنْ يُؤْذَنَ لَكُمْ إِلَى طَعَامٍ غَيْرَ نَاظِرِينَ إِنَاهُ وَلَكِنْ إِذَا دُعِيتُمْ فَادْخُلُوا فَإِذَا طَعِمْتُمْ فَانْتَشِرُوا. All you who believe, enter not the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam houses except when leave is given to you for a meal, and then not so early as to wait for its preparation, but when you are invited, enter. And when you have taken your meal, disperse. Without sitting for a talk. Be simple. Because I am busy. I was busy maybe 3 hours preparing for the dinner. Go to the supermarket, buy the meat, the chicken, the fish, the water, the juices, and helping my wife. Maybe every half an hour, my wife asked me to bring this more from the... So imagine if you are at home, you will not give me the chance to prepare for the dinner. So don't come waiting for the food. Wait until I give you the permission. So when I give you the permission, come. Yalla, say Bismillah, eat. You are welcome now. After you finish, leave. Because I am tired. I was busy 3, 4, 5 hours. And especially if you invited a big number, maybe 1, 2 days you are preparing for this meeting or for this meal. Okay, so don't give any pressure to the person who invited you. Okay, maybe he invited only 1 or 2 people and he ordered from the restaurant and he likes that you sit with him to chat with him. Okay, it's okay if you are sure that he likes this. Okay, but if you feel that he is tired, he likes to spend time with his family, he wants to take rest, طيب. So leave after eating your food. طيب.